General Mills, a flour conglomerate. In 1928, nothing looked crazier. But now, let's see what happened. In short order, 4 flour mills became 27 across 16 American states. The biggest flour miller in America, and then the biggest in the world. But they didn't stop with flour. General Mills bought us Cheerios and Lucky Charms. They briefly became the world's biggest toy company. They designed the underwater equipment that investigated the Titanic. They dabbled with Star Wars merchandising and made a fortune at it. And they gave us that woman who's still in the larder, Betty Crocker, the baking immortal, who, in 1945, was the second most popular woman in America, after Eleanor Roosevelt. In the 90s, they joined forces with Nestlé and General Mills as cereal partners worldwide. Nesquik and Nestea are just a couple of the results. Then came PepsiCo, and yet more diversification. Snacks. By 2004, what was once the world's biggest toy company was now Europe's biggest snack maker. Today, General Mills is not just an American powerhouse, but a global powerhouse, with brands as relevant today as they were 70 years ago. You can read all about its astonishing history, the jinx, the direction changes, the coups and the blues in FMCG, the power of fast-moving consumer goods. FMCG, The Power of Fast-Moving Consumer Goods, is a brand new book by Greg Thain and John Bradley. A comprehensive history of the world's top FMCGs. A must-buy for anyone in or studying the trillion-dollar world of FMCG. Available now on Amazon, Barnes & Noble, Kindle, Abe Books, and other leading online bookstores.